starting lineup for the Flying Dutch. Leading off, number 4, center fielder Robbie Stursma. Batting second, number 9, right fielder Charlie Saul. Batting third, number 6, first baseman Owen Krizan. Batting fourth, number 3, designated hitter Cade Seaball. Batting fifth, number 16, left fielder Brendan Collins. Batting sixth, number 8, second baseman Nolan Gardner. Batting seventh, number 11, shortstop Devin Musin. Batting eighth, number 2, third baseman Al Money. Batting ninth, number 5, catcher Andrew Pickett. And pitching for the Flying Dutch, number 32, Jake Van Dam. The Flying Dutch are coached by head coach Stu Fritz and assisted by Chad Ruby, Rick Heisman, Devin Schaefers, and Ryan Durrell. Now for the home team, the Hornets of Kalamazoo. Leading off, senior number 3, shortstop Cooper Mills. Batting second, number 9, the catcher Harrison Polzad. Batting third, number 7, third baseman Ryer Reinhardt. Batting fourth, number 10, left fielder Tanner Hawkins. Batting fifth, number 14, second baseman David Stechow. Batting sixth, number 23, first baseman Robert Newland. Batting seventh, number 17, the designated hitter Alex Fenkel. Batting eighth, number 18, right fielder Logan Lockhart. Batting ninth, number 33, the center fielder Lucas Bolton. And pitching for the Hornets, number 2, Gabe Sokol. Kalamazoo is coached by Mike Ott, assisted by Matt Ellenbest, Brendan Craig, JP McBride, Matt Rayfelt, and Ryan Beadle. Now, would you please rise, gentlemen, remove your caps, and face the flag located in center field to honor your country with the playing of the national anthem.
Hey folks, good afternoon. Thanks so much for tuning in today for Hornet Baseball. From Woodworth Field at Kalamazoo College, I'm Tanner White with Kalamazoo College Baseball. This is just the second home outing of the season for the Hornets. 5 recent rainouts have all changed to road games, and all Kalamazoo has done is go 14-2 on the road in response. They come into play at 19-7 overall, 8-3 in MIAA play. A crucial rivalry game today on deck against Hope College, playing for that top spot in the MIAA standings. The Dust just swept Olivet and took it to them. They're 15-12 overall, but again, crucially have that one game lead in the MIAA standings at 9-2. Thanks once again for joining us. First pitch scheduled for about 4 p.m., and we should be right about on track for it. The Hornets are going to send Gabe Sokol to the mound here for the single game. Numbers on Sokol coming in. This is actually his first start for the season. Record of 1-0 in 6 appearances, 6 2/3 innings, 4 hits, just 1 earned run so far, and 8 strikeouts for 10.8 Ks per 9. That 1 run allowed is good enough for a 1.35 ERA. He's going to face Robbie Stersma. As we prepare to lead it off, ball's in, coming down. First throw from Pozat. And Mills over there to cover the bag. Now Robbie Stersma and Gabe Sokol ready to get this game underway. Here comes pitch number one. You got one left-hander way down in the lineup at sixth with Nolan Gardner for the Dutch. And the Hornets have one at seventh. First pitch for Stersma is a little flare right to first base. Rob Newland hauls it in. One pitch and one out. Gabe Sokol putting away Robbie Stersma.
Up to bat, number 9, Charlie Saul.
One pitch, one out from Sokol. Saul, the right fielder, is next. This one's going to end up at the backstop. No harm, no foul. Charlie Saul, sophomore outfielder. Sokol missed a little bit low. Primarily just fastball slider for Sokol. Two-pitch approach, but it's worked pretty well, like we said, those 6 2/3. Now 7 innings, just one earned run, rather, for the year. Down low, 3-0. Numbers on Charlie Saul. Comes in hitting .328 on the year. Mostly a full-time starter. One triple, as well as 7 doubles out of 20 hits on the year. Slugging .475. Sokol outside one more time. 4-pitch walk. Charlie Saul, first base runner. Lots of on-base machines in that Dutch lineup. They've got a .403 team on-base percentage. Hornets as a team still have an outstanding sort of video game-like .446 team OBP, as well as hitting well over .300 as a whole lineup. Sokol's back with a strike this time, finds it. Pop-up and a walk from the first two hitters. Owen Krizan, first baseman. Looks at one right towards the top of the zone in the off-speed, 0-2. Sokol's got the swing and miss stuff. Chance to maybe throw a slider in the dirt, get a chase from Krizan. Exactly what he was thinking, missed a little bit too far in the other batter's box. Tough time to call upon Sokol to make his first start for the year. 1-2, same spot, down and away. Sokol's been all away from him so far this at-bat. No reason to give in now. That looks really close on that outside black. Pozat held it there an extra tick longer, and no luck. Run it full. Second career start from Gabe Sokol. Started one game last year and also recorded one save. Full count pitch is down and away one more time. Two base runners on for the Dutch here in the first inning. Pop up now, a couple of walks. Cleanup hitter for the Dutch is Cade Seabaugh. Seabaugh's a .356 hitter. Not quite enough at-bats to qualify the minimum 2 plate appearances a game, but .356 would lead this team. 3 home runs as well in 16 games. Ball's down at his feet. Pozat with a great scoop. Holds the runners right where they are. Seaball listed in their starting lineup as a right-hander. Looks like he switch hits as he's up here from the left side this time. And Pozat's out to the mound. Going to have a quick chat with Gabe Sokol. Tried to go back foot slider, just got a little bit too much down and in. Harrison Pozat, the catcher. Take this as a good time to set the rest of the infield for you. Over at first base for the Hornets, Robert Newland. Second base, David Steckow. Third base, Ryer Reinhart. And shortstop, Cooper Mills. You got real relaxed depth up the middle. And this one's in the dirt. It's going to move those runners up. Likely wild pitch on Sokol. Runners on second and third now. One out. Just got a little bit more difficult here in that first inning. Sokol might be sweating for other reasons besides the heat today. Boy, we skipped right over the spring and we're playing summer baseball. 74 in the Zoo. This is a grounder through the right side. That's a base hit. One run's going to score. They're going to hold up the next one. It was a good turn and a good relay as Newland was ready to throw that runner out at the plate. RBI single from Owen Krizen. Or rather, Cade Seabaugh. My apologies. And Steckow, again, with the real relaxed depth, is playing right on the cut of the outfield grass and far from the bag at second. Just a good piece of hitting. Pull it on that hole on the right side. Big cut and a miss from Brendan Collins. Coming out of his shoes. Collins is a left fielder. He's a sophomore from the Kalamazoo area, went to Hackett. And ended up in Holland on the 0-1. Now he's frozen, takes one right down the middle. Owen Krizen on third. Just had Seabaugh with the RBI single, 1-0 Dutch. Sokol bounces another one. Pozat thought he had it blocked for a moment, but that's going to move up another runner. Same situation now as the last hitter. Got a couple of wild pitches in the inning. Back with a 1-2. That's way high and deep. Still traveling. That thing's out of here. Wasn't quite sure about that off the bat, but Collins has a dog in him. He just muscled that thing out. It's a 3-run homer. Brendan Collins off of Gabe Sokol. And a quiet start in Woodworth. It was a fastball, a little bit up, a little bit in. But if you're going to do that, go ahead and throw it all the way up at his eyes. Get a little bit further up and in. And then a hit by pitch. Hornets already got to get guys up and throwing in that bullpen. To say it's not how you drew it up would be an understatement. That was Nolan Gardner who just got hit there on the first pitch. Devin Mewson's due up next. Here's Matt Ellenbest trotting out to the mound. And overall, shock is the emotion we're feeling. Brendan Collins, that blast out to left field. Made it almost all the way over to that fence there before the houses. Thought off the bat that Tanner Hawkins had that thing lined up. So Hawkins is in left field. Again, we'll finish setting the defense here. Lucas Bolton, been patrolling center field for a number of years now. And Logan Lockhart out in right with Alex Finkel, the DH, and the only lefty in the Hornets lineup. Sokol's got to come back to the game plan.
Number 11, Devin Musin.
Get the feeling, though, that they're probably going to have to change that a little bit and not have him work as deep as they would have liked. Just might not have the option. This is a line drive from Musin over Mills at short, base hit. And that's a late turn. That runner's heading in for third. What a great throw just under that tag in time. Tanner Hawkins nearly hosed that runner. Very, very aggressive. But that's the Dutch's MO. They run early and often. 62 steals in 81 attempts on the season for over a 75% clip. They're known for taking the extra bases on plays just like that. Devin Musin is the next one with a hit. Four runs on two hits in the inning. You had a couple of walks, two wild pitches. And Ellenbest coming out again. Are they already going to make the change? Al Money is due up for the Dutch. He's the eighth hitter. The only one left in the lineup is Pickett, the catcher, who would be next. And Sokol, his day will be done. Misspoke as well on that last single from Musin. That's four runs now on three hits for the Dutch. The big blow, of course, that three-run homer from Brendan Collins. And Sokol's day is done. Pitching change coming up in just a moment for the Hornets. Gabe Sokol's not going to get out of this inning. Chase Cummins is the Hornets' arm, and they're going to be forced to burn through that bullpen at some point. Now, Cummins has started games in the past. That gives you a decent chance of getting some real long relief out of him, you know, say 3-4-plus innings. You got to try and get as many as you can at this point. But Cummins, again, a good guy to do it. All the runners are going to be, rather the two runners on base right now are going to be owned by Sokol. So his line not done yet. Numbers on Chase Cummins for the year. He started one game. Again, he's been a spot starter before in his career. Thrown 7 2/3 innings in 5 appearances. 1-1 record. 10 hits given up. 4.70 ERA. That's 4 earned runs in those 7 2/3 so far. Cummins in as tough a spot as anybody. Called on to face Al Money. He's often hit ninth during his career, moved up to eighth spot this season, and always a productive guy. Comes in hitting .329 with 18 RBI on the season. Shows bunt. It's a good one. Great sacrifice. And Money gets another run in. Second sacrifice bunt on the year. 5-0 Dutch, and we're not quite out of the inning yet. Still one more runner in scoring position. Now it's Chase Cummins and Andrew Pickett. One more earned run for Sokol. Cummins off speed across for a strike. Runner taken off on the pitch. What an incredible jump. With two outs, Pozat wasn't even going to chance it with a throw down there. And it's 0-2 on the hitter. coming still. Can get out of this thing and stem the bleeding a bit. Swing and a miss. That he does. After the Meuson stolen base. One runner stranded at third, but five in on three hits. The big blow, the three-run homer from Brendan Collins. Hornets bats have their work cut out for them. Headed to the bottom of the first in a moment. Hornets about ready to come to bat here in the bottom of the first inning with a 5-0 deficit. They got a lot of good bats at the top of the order to overcome that. Cooper Mills, Harrison Pozat, Ryer Reinhart, your 1-2-3 hitters. Tanner Hawkins, David Steckow, Rob Newland, 4-5-6. And then 7-8-9 is Alex Finkel, again the one lefty. Logan Lockhart and Lucas Bolton. Offensive numbers for the Hornets this year, outstanding in a ton of ways. They average just a tick under 10 runs a game. Their team is batting .322. Again, we mentioned they're on base back in the top of the first. It's .446, and they slug .448. Those are almost identical. Power in terms of the home runs is down a little bit from the last several years with 13 home runs this season to date, but 80 extra base hits overall is a great number. First pitch from Jake Van Dam coming, the Hope righty. And it's on the inside corner. That's a great spot. Hard to get hurt too bad there with Van Dam. A little bit up and a little bit more in this time. Numbers on Jake Van Dam. He comes in with a .450 ERA, making his second start on the season, worked 12 innings, 6 earned runs. Off the foul ball, 1-2. Cooper Mills just recently set the Hornets program record for runs scored, 123 and counting. OBP at .472 as well. You can see the catcher Pickett holding that, just like Pozat tried to do in the first inning, but no luck there. Mills, quintessential leadoff hitter, also driven in 19 from that leadoff spot. He's frozen that time, and he is set down. I'm glad I didn't get a chance to mention just how tough he is to strike out. He had punched out 8 times in 94 at-bats. Talking about once out of every 12 trips or so. But Van Dam got him right on the inside corner. Now Harrison Pozat, Hornets all-world fifth-year catcher. He's got 5 home runs on the year, 44 RBIs, has by far the program record in terms of career RBIs, career hit by pitches, career doubles, puts up numbers. He's quickly down 0-2 as well. Jake Van Dam doing a good job getting ahead. First pitch strikes so far. Pozat's got 18 extra base hits. Again, 44 RBIs leads the team, hitting .352. Just above the top of the zone. Close pitch. And maybe on the full count, Pozat would pull the trigger on that. Skied way high to right. That sun's going to be tough. That thing coming in, and it dropped. That's about as deep of a bloop single as you'll see.
Number 7, Ryer Reinhart.
Out there in right field trying to scoop that thing was Saul. Now we'll set the rest of the Dutch defense. Saul in right field. Center fielder is Robbie Stersma. Left field, Brendan Collins, who hit the home run in the first inning. Owen Krizan at first base. Devin Gardner at second. Devin Mewson at short. Al Money at third. And as we mentioned, the catcher, Andrew Pickett. Reinhardt sprayed this one foul. If you recall Ryer Reinhardt's season from last year, he hit 10 home runs. That was the Hornets single season record. Drove in 72. National leader in RBIs per game, pulls this one foul. Hornets single season records for those home runs and RBIs. MIAA position player of the year. Just staggering numbers all around and hasn't been quite at that same level yet. They check over on Pozat. Probably not going to see that again this at bat. Pozat's got one steal on the year and also been caught once. Stays 0-2. Pozat for his whole career is 7 of 11 in stolen bases. He's got better things to do. Reinhardt charge into this ball to left center, and it just died right by the track. Sounded good off the bat. Tanner Hawkins will be next. Hawkins has been one of the most impossible outs in the MIAA this year. Comes in hitting .435 and a .557 on-base percentage. That is almost 56% of at-bats ending with him on base. Absurd. Takes the ball high. Hawkins has walked 14 times. Known for getting hit by a pitch. Has a home run and 10 doubles. All around, just filling up that stat sheet. And that outside corner is nowhere to be found for either of the pitchers. Or I suppose all three of the pitchers so far, with Cummins coming in as well. Two-oh from Hawkins, popped him up. Right on the edge of the grass, Mewson called it and makes the catch. The Hornets get the single from Pozat, the real soft bloop single, and he's stranded at first. Chase Cummins likely coming back out for the top of the second, and the Dutch went all the way around 1-9 in the first, meaning Robbie Stersma is going to lead off the top of the second. As Pozat was on base, took a moment to get the catching gear on. Now he's out there, and Cummins tuning up, ready for his second inning of work. Cummins got the last two outs. Gabe Sokol only able to get the one, and his lines finishes third of an inning, three hits, five earned, the two walks, and of course the big problem, the three-run homer from Brendan Collins. Now Chase Cummins and Robbie Stersma here in the top of the second. Stersma retired on one pitch his first time, so no shock he took a strike this time. Robbie's a .263 career hitter against Kalamazoo. This is at bat number 59 for him against the Hornets in his career. 0-2. Struck out 20 times in those 58 at-bats, but also has had some games with some damage. Time awarded here. Robbie really hit the Hornets well last year, 8 of 19 with a home run and 7 RBIs. And this one stroked well, but not too far from the right fielder, Lockhart. Pop out, line out for Starzma. Now Saul and Krizan both walked off of Sokol. Both came in to score. Great pitch again from Cummins. His control on point so far. That was part of the reason that Sokol got hurt, was just putting those two guys on, and then he had to give Collins such a good pitch to hit. Newland running way over, bumps up against that fence, and it's just too far. Cummins been ahead of pretty much everybody 0-2 so far, and all of his at-bats started with first pitch strikes. Oh, Pozat held it again. Where's that outside corner? He'll find it eventually. Just might not get any of the called strikes there today, it looks like. Cummins 1-2. And softly on the infield, popped it up. Cummins calls it. Hauls it in.
Now batting number 6, Owen Krizan.
Cummins not huge on strikeouts. One of those kind of rare pitchers that often gets fly balls and manages to limit the damage. That's what we've seen from him so far. Fly out, now a pop-up. All first pitch strikes. This one on Krizan. Seabaugh, Collins, Mayusin all had RBIs. Cummins keeps pouring in the strikes. 13 pitches so far. On the 0-2, soft tap to third. Reinhardt got to hurry a little bit. Great throw right in the chest. And they're out of the inning. That is a rapid shot in the arm. Chase Cummins now worked an inning in 2/3 in relief. And the bats get to come right back out here for the bottom of the second. Here's Jake Van Dam, back out for the bottom of the second, facing David Steckow. Van Dam threw 16 pitches, had one strikeout, gave up that really soft bloop single to Pozat. It fell in the end. It was a great diving effort from Saul as well. Just came up short. Steckow back up the box and a base hit. That thing is scalded. Leads these Hornets now with 44 hits on the year and hitting almost .450. Have mercy. On base percentage also over .500. Some of these individual stat lines just don't even make sense. Leadoff hitter on. Now Rob Newland, the first baseman. Newland had exactly the same idea, but got off speed and timing not quite there. Rob Newland hitting 329 coming into play. Up at the eyes, little buzz cut. Newland, once he gets on to, is a speed threat. He leads the Hornets and steals with 13 of them. If stolen base is about an 82% clip. Foul off his hands. Newland gets on base at a fantastic clip as well. Lots of those have come on hit by pitches. Not necessarily something to brag about, but it's notable. He's been hit 18 times. Nobody else in this lineup's been hit more than 10. Going to be a tough guy to double off on a ground ball, too. Runs well. That outside corner still not there. Van Dam works it. Cummins works it. Sokol tried multiple times. And nobody getting those called strikes. Van Dam, 2-2. Cut through and missed. Two strikeouts for Van Dam. Here comes Alex Fenkel. Fenkel's hitting 352 himself, no slouch. And another tough guy to struck out. Punches out about once out of every nine ABs. 463 on base. Has one home run as well. A little bit down low for ball one. Fenkel finding himself a full-time starter. As a freshman, was more of a defensive replacement and got his at-bats now and then. He's up in the head, up in the count rather, 2-0. And up and in, nearly wore that one in the ribs. 3-0, Steckow already on base with the base hit. Got to be taken all the way. Logan Lockhart is next. And he did take down the pipe. He was ready to toss that bat. Fenkel is the rare left-handed swinging and right-handed throwing infielder. Though DHing today. 3-1, right back to the up and in. And he missed. Two on. As we get to the bottom of the order, ready to turn it over. Lockhart's got big pop. Got big on base numbers. Can steal a base once in a while. Tough to strike out. And he's a super utility, too. In the outfield and as a pitcher this year have been excellent. And this ball is scalded to left. Ooh, as that left fielder came in really far, I thought that was going to be tough to catch it over his head, but Collins ends up hauling it in. That is a good adjustment off the bat because those first few steps were not going to take him to the ball. Two outs, two on. Lucas Bolton, center fielder, local Kalamazoo product from Kalamazoo Central. And he cuts that one in the dirt. That's just not quite far enough away. Bolton comes in hitting 237 so far, driven in 19. Been real good in runners on and scoring position situations. Watches a strike this time. Hornets would really love to get at least one back here. Starting off in that 5-0 hole. Bolton's a career 300 hitter. Spoils it. And Bolton's accumulated a lot of stats himself. He's got 5 career home runs, 4 triples, sitting on 30 doubles and 79 RBI. Go along with 35 stolen bases. He's a vet. Has some great outfield throws to his name. Highlights all around. Good ball player. Gotta protect. Van Dam's 0-2. And in at the back foot. One ball, two strikes. Situation doesn't change a whole lot. Van Dam probably going to go back down and in again. Maybe try and find that outside corner, but it hasn't been there. So he goes up and in this time. Base runners are Steckow and Fenkel. Single and a walk. Bolt's got a 2-2 count. Runners off on the pitch. And this is softly lined to center. And handled by Sturzma. Horners get base runners again. The leadoff single, then the walk from Fenkel. Both are stranded. Jake Van Dam cruising so far with a couple of strikeouts and no earned. Hornets still trail 5-0 as we head to the top of the third. Chase Cummins and Cade Seabaugh now for the top of the third. Seabaugh, RBI single the first time. That was the first run of the ball game. Saul came in there, then Brendan Collins had the 3-run homer to dead left and deep. That brought in Seabaugh as well as Krizan. And then Al Money with one perfect sack bunt. Those were the 5 runs, all in that top of the first that chased Gabe Sokol. Cummins outside, fastball. 2 balls, 1 strike. Best news for Cummins, I think, is he only threw 14 pitches to get to this point through an inning and 2/3. Now he does have a chance to work deep in long relief. And now for the left-handed batters, nobody can find that outside corner either. Really appreciating it as all of our pitchers continue to work there and try and get the called strikes. Can't do it. 3-1. Scalded to short. Mills, Fields, and the throw in the chest. Hot off the bat. Mills position just right. Now my bold prediction in this at-bat, Cummins not challenging Collins, especially not with high fastballs. First one's in the dirt. Collins came in hitting 286. That was his third home run. Tied for that team lead with Seaball. Tipped into the glove, first strike two. Dutch hit three home runs yesterday against Olivet, the game they took it to him. And they swept that series comfortably. Cummins with a strike across. It's 1-2. Another in the dirt. Cummins threw his two innings so far. Pretty much perfect. This one is stroked right to Mills. That ball caught him.
Now batting number eight, Nolan.
Infield been perfectly positioned so far on every hitter. Cummins and Gardner. He was hit by a pitch on the first pitch of the at-bat against Sokol. Cummins still all first pitch strikes. Beautiful. That was pitch number 25. Same spot, painted. That's pretty. 0-2. Bit high that time. Cummins a chance to get out of another inning in the blink of an eye. Nolan Gardner still down in the count, 1-2. Somehow, he got a piece. Remember those five runs scored on just three hits? All the hits against Sokol. Cummins still yet to give one up. Little outside. Pozat's almost sort of, with his body language, given up on trying to get that outside strike call. You see what he sees. Cummins, 2-2. And bounced another run at full. 0-2 back to 3-2. That's a skill all its own. Working an at-bat like that and making a guy who is absolutely cruising just throw a lot more pitches. Full count is outside for ball four. Dutch with a base runner here.
Number 11, Devin Musin.
Musin had a single. It was a line drive over the head of Mills. He came in hitting only about 200. Just 9 RBIs. As a full-time starter, that's not what the Dutch were expecting of him. Also been hit by 16 pitches. It's funny how certain guys seem to attract that baseball. Cummins with another first pitch strike, by the way. Way over the top. And 0-2. Cummins went back outside corner and off speed. He's thrown a number in the dirt. Dutch hitters really haven't chased anything yet. I think it bears trying one more time on an 0-2 pitch. It is down low and it's golfed out to left. Hawkins lines it up and a can of corn. One walk, one runner stranded. Chase Cummins keeps it right where it's at. Still low. Hornets bats need to get going here in the bottom of the third. Thank you. Hornets turn their lineup over as we head to the bottom of the third. Cooper Mills and Jake Van Dam. Van Dam has two hits allowed and a walk. 21, now 22 strikes out of 35 pitches. About 65%, that's a good number. And he can live with that, struck out two as well. Mills slowly to short, deep in the hole. Long throw from Mjusin in time. Lots of veteran experience on that Dutch infield. Shows up there. Pozat and Stecko have the Hornet base hits so far. He had that flare out to right. That just missed the top of the zone apparently this time. 37 pitches now for Van Dam. Now there's the outside corner, 1-1. Pozat sitting on 38 hits now on the year. Golfs for one, came up empty. He's not up here to walk. Pozat's walked nine times in now 106 at-bats. About once out of every 12. Ooh, over his head. Came out of the hand funny. Van Dam just shakes it off. Ooh, he needs time. You wonder if he's got a little hangnail or something. Told the home plate umpire, yeah, something's not right with me. Just give me a moment here. It looks like he may have bit off that hangnail. You got to do what you got to do to stay in the game. Now the 2-2. And got him. Goes fishing twice in that at-bat. Van Dam, three punch-outs. And Dam's not overwhelming anybody, but boy, commanding all his pitches and winning the mental game. Reinhardt hit a ball on the screws to left center his first time. Check swing and probably a strike anyway. Hornets yet to really threaten Van Dam. Outside corner, 0-2. Reinhardt could change that at any moment with a single swing. Got himself two home runs. And 12 for his career. A little bit high. Van Dam continues pouring in the strikes. Now that one ran in close to the hands. Hornets had two on last inning. They had the single from Steckow, then a walk. Couldn't score anybody. Another 2-2. And right back at him. That thing could have been dangerous. Base hit, Reinhardt. Van Dam made the business decision to get out of the way. Tanner Hawkins now with a runner on. And now, for whatever reason, that outside corner has been discovered. Both Van Dam and Cummins just continue to pour it in there, especially the first pitch and off in the fastball. Those are related. Slow on the ground to short. They're going to go to second, get the out there, and fielder's choice. One more base runner on the single from Reinhardt. One more runner stranded. 5-0 is the Dutch lead. We head to the top of the fourth. So in what has become a de facto start for Chase Cummins, he's ready for inning number three of work. Worked 2 2/3 so far in only 34 pitches. Al Money had the great sack bunt the first time. Textbook pushed it towards the mound between the pitcher and the first base. And there was no play but to go to first with it. So no official at bat yet. Now an official at bat. That's a base hit through the left side. Got the single, got the RBI. Not quite on the same play, but Money will take it. Back to the nine spot, Andrew Pickett, the catcher.
Andrew Pickett.
Pickett had the one Dutch strikeout so far. That was against Cummins. That was the last out to get out of the inning. He showed bunt as well. Might be a good thing that Cummins put that ball in the dirt. But now you got Reinhardt, who's going through his pockets there at the plate. Four or five steps inside the cut of the grass. And he's still going to try and put that thing down. It's a great bunt toward the pitcher, and Cummins had to get the runner at first.
Now batting number four, Robbie Sturzma.
So the Dutch have already hit one way deep on the three-run homer by Collins, and they played some small ball. That was home run number 15 for them here in game number 28. Dutch came in 15 and 12. Hornets came in 19 and 7. But remember, the MIAA standings, those are what we're interested in. This game playing for first place. 1-1, Cummins and Sturzma. He showed bunt too. And now you wonder, if Sturzma was planning to bunt that thing towards the first base side, like he was squared up to do, then he's looking to do that for a base hit. That's what it looked like from here. Now 0-2, irrelevant. Bunt is off. Time right before Cummins made the delivery. And a long break here. Wonder if the umpire writing something in the pocketbook there? Couldn't tell. Cummins still getting ahead of absolutely everybody. Really commendable job throwing strikes. And again, this is essentially his start at this point. Down and away. Remember, Sturzma's punched out 20 times against Kalamazoo in 59 at-bats, 0-2 today. Hornets often known for doing a good job on him. Now this one headed to the gap. That's a problem. Run's going to score. He's taking that turn, too. And that throw nowhere to be found. It's a double from Robbie Sturzma. 6-0 Dutch. Another runner on second. Saul, another chance. And another run in. Earned run to Cummins. Still, first pitch strikes, incredible. Can't say enough about it. Charlie Saul, 0-1, plus a walk. Cummins going to throw back that thing in shallow center. Good job from Steckow to back it up. Don't imagine that they're going to try and pick back behind him again. Now, of course, they're concerned about him. Robbie Sturzma, by the way, the MIAA leader in stolen bases, so very right to be that way. 20 steals in 23 attempts. And especially with one out, it would be huge to get him over. This will get him over, by the way. It's a ground ball for second. And Steckow threw him out. Ended up being pretty close. as the ball just wasn't hit very hard.
Now batting number six, Owen Krizan.
Owen Krizan, RBI chance as Sturzma moved over to third base. Pozat held it there one more time. And one of the very few at-bats didn't start with a strike. Krizan 0 for 1 with a walk as well. Coming out of his shoes, cut and missed. One and one. That makes 47 pitches for Cummins. Six runs on five hits for the Dutch. Just two of those hits off of Cummins, three off of the starter, Gabe Sokol. Little up and in. Cummins, the 2-2 to escape in the dirt. Krizan up now with the full count. C-ball would be next. Do not want to see Collins in this inning. Full count pitch. And that's headed back to center field. RBI single. 7-0. Dutch lead. These two teams have played games with absolute absurdities. You really just can't take any lead for granted. 7-0 seems commanding, but we have seen crazier things happen, even in just the last couple of years. We've had a 13-inning game that went a little over 4 hours. We've had a walk-off, which Harrison Pozat famously hit with a walk-off sack fly call from yours truly. Whole bunch of dramatic things just seem to happen here at the Wood. If you're the Dutch, you have to give the most credit today, I think, to Jake Van Dam. As their offense cooks, Van Dam just gets ahead of guys, throws strikes, and has scattered three hits, one walk, and struck out three. Cummins and Cade Seabaugh. And that clip, the very bottom of the zone, that helps him out a whole lot. Sturzma has the RBI double in this inning. Then Krizan, the single, to bring in two. Seven runs, six hits. Going to check on him over at first. Newland blocks it on the backhand. Seabaugh has an RBI himself. Again, he drove in the very first run of the game. No runs, three hits for Kalamazoo so far. And this ball is smoked. Deposited into short right field, long turn, and he's going to be into third easy. Seabaugh now a couple of hits. He's the first guy to have two hits today, in fact. And just as I said, you don't want to face Collins. Well, here it comes. Those other innings been way less stressful. This one will not be that way for Cummins. Sits at 53 pitches now. Collins with a chance to sort of put this game to bed. But it's hard to even say that with the kind of offense that they're facing. The Hornets offense, again, averaged just a tick under 10 runs a game so far. Through 26 games, they had scored 256 runs. One of the best offenses in the nation behind you. You just got to try and keep it where it is. Every single inning that you get guys on, limit the damage as much as possible. Cummins has got guys up throwing in the bullpen. But boy, you really need to see him get Collins here to start feeling better about where you're at. ahead 0-2. Stroke to right. Couple of awkward steps in, and then Lockhart retreats and makes the catch. Cummins survives. Two runs in, though, in that top of the fourth. Seven runs on seven hits for the Dutch. Hornet bats ready for the bottom of the fourth. Steckow and Jake Van Dam here in the bottom of the fourth. Van Dam, three innings so far, three strikeouts, three hits, one walk. That all-important zero in the runs. I think Steckow was called on that check swing. He singled right back up the box, almost hit Van Dam. And that's been his approach. That was how he was able to drive in over a run per game last year as a guy that's not going to hit the ball out of the ballpark. But been hitting for a ton of average for a long time. And he's an absolute staple. Big swing and a miss. Steckow out of there. I was just about to mention, too, that his average coming into today, before you factor in that base hit, was 33rd in the nation. Hornets got lots of top performers in really tons of different categories all across their lineup. And Sekau's been one of the very best, but he's punched out there. Jake Van Dam is twirling so far. First pitch was in the dirt there to Newland. Shallow center field. Sturzma drifts over. Long way to go, but he got there. And a real quick two-pitch out.
Now batting number 17, Alex Finkel.
Van Dam's been around a long time. He's a fifth year. But this might be the finest start of his career. He is authoring one. He did just have a really strong start against Alma back 10 days ago. Threw five innings, gave up only one hit, but walked four in that game. That was a blowout. The Dutch won that one 12-0, and not a lot of teams are doing that to Alma, too. Really quickly, 0-2 on Finkel. Van Dam feeling himself. Has about 50 innings thrown for his career. And this is just, it doesn't look at all like a guy who's only thrown 50 innings. Looks like a star out there. This is real shallow to center. Sturzma again coming on. Strikeout, fly out, fly out. And if you blink, you missed it. Jake Van Dam. dominating the Hornets lineup so far. 7-0, the Dutch still lead, headed to the fifth inning. Didn't necessarily know we were going to be getting this, but it's a pitching change for the Hornets here for the top of the fifth. Reese Amodio is on for Chase Cummins. Amodio, a really big, tall right-hander, stands 6'5", 210, freshman from Southgate. He's going to have to face Nolan Gardner. Cummins finishes with 3 2/3 worked, 4 hits, 2 runs, 1 walk, 1 strikeout. That one double from Sturzma hurt a lot. And then he was forced to give a really good pitch to hit to Krizan the at-bat after that. And those were how the two runs scored. Cummins really shut everything down besides that. And those two runs in the top of the fourth have made this game feel like a long shot for Kalamazoo. They got a long way to go. Amodio and Nolan Gardner ready here for the top of the fifth.
Nolan Gardner.
Hit by pitch and a walk. No at-bats so far for Gardner. Amodio a little low on that first pitch. The numbers on Amodio go 7 appearances so far, 7 innings. 5 runs, 4 earned, 4 strikeouts, 3 walks. Down by his foot, 2-0. All right-handers so far. Sokol, Cummins, and Amodio. Sprayed foul. Really just not a ton of left-handed options. Kalamazoo typically has more of those that they look to bring in. You know, every class, ideally, you'd like to have one or two really good left-handed relievers. Haven't had many of them come around here in a while. After that foul ball, it's 2-2. Amodio steps off time. Another foul ball. 7 runs, 7 hits, Dutch. No runs, 3 hits, Hornets. Those first 5 for Hope were all in that first inning, and then 2 more in the fourth. Brendan Collins still has the biggest swing of this game with that home run out to dead left that brought in 3. This one is tagged, heading to that right center field gap. It drops, and in there with a stand-up double. How rudely Reese Amodio just got greeted. That's the first official at-bat for Gardner. Ends with a double. Amodio to the backstop and way back there. Pozat's got a hurrier. He could almost, that runner could have almost taken the turn and thought about coming in. That ball ended up at the on deck circle. Amodio's job just got even more difficult if he's going to have any chance. Now they pull in the infield, a chance to go home with it on a ground ball if that runner is moving on contact. There's never a guarantee of that. Officially wild pitch from Gardner, rather from Amodio that moves up Gardner. Two and oh. Amodio to the backstop again, and that run's gonna score. Eight, nothing. Wheels falling off. Double, wild pitch, wild pitch. A run in and nobody out yet. Amodio behind 3-0. And make it a four-pitch walk.
Now batting number two, Al Money.
Hornets right away get more guys up and throwing. Al Money, sack bunt, RBI, plus a single. Also a run scored. Time called here. Going to talk to the third base coach, rather. Hope's hitting 6 of 10 with runners on so far and 4 out of 7 with runners in scoring position. Scary. Money offered with the bunt, even fouled it off somehow. Dutch are already beyond their scoring average per game. And there aren't that many offenses scoring 8 to 10 runs a game. Kalamazoo just happens to be one of them. But they're getting it taken to them so far. 1-1. Double, 2 wild pitches, a walk so far. Again, nobody out in the 5th inning. Had a foul ball out on the field. Looked like Brendan Oprinsky went and tracked that thing down over by the tarp. Softly hit and shallow to left. Hawkins, can of corn. Now one merciful out is great, and you keep money off the base paths too. This would be a phenomenal time to double off Andrew Pickett. Modio's already thrown 13 pitches. Jake Van Dam still dealing 38 strikes out of 57 pitches for 67%, as that is shot foul. The line on Van Dam so far, 4 innings, 4 strikeouts, 3 hits, 1 walk, and nothing more. Hard to even blame the Hornets' offensive approach, and they've had some base runners. With that huge lead, now the offense has really got to press. Remodio and Andrew Pickett. Again, he struck out against Cummins. And another one this time. Remodio got him.
Now batting number four, Robbie Sturzma.
That helps a lot. Fly out, strike out. Now Sturzma still gets a chance with a runner on, but two outs. Took one down the pipe. Robbie today, a double, and an RBI double at that for three. Also scored a run. Pop this one, mile high. Newland and Pozat. Pozat called it in a little athletic catch with the adjustment at the end. Ended up a bit of a back bend, but he hauled it in. Remodio gives up the one run, the double, couple wild pitches. And that Dutch lead does move to 8-0. Jake Van Dam back out for the bottom of the fifth. Eight, nine, one hitters. Lockhart, Bolton, then Cooper Mills to turn it over. Van Dam a little bit inside. That's pitch number 58 for the day. Twirling one so far. Lockhart with a hot shot. What a catch down there. At the hottest of corners, Al Money can pick him.
Now batting number 33, Lucas Bolden.
Can't hit it much harder from Lockhart. Bolton takes one a little bit outside. You got three guys with a hit so far, Pozat, Reinhardt, Steckow. Haven't strung any hits together yet. Only time they had two runners on was back in the second inning. Steckow, then Fenkel. Bolt on the appeal, he held up. Bolton's got 2-1. Expect him to sit fastball. He got it way up and in. The 3-1 is right down the middle.
Thank you.
Bolton way deep in the hole. Musin stopped it. Long throw with the scoop, and they got him. I don't know who to credit more there, Krizan or Musin. Got no complaints on defense from either side. Gloves are active. Really, though, that catch from Money, that could have been a doubleheaded all the way down the left field line from Lockhart. That ball was hot. And strike one to Mills. Had a rare strikeout leading off in the bottom of the first inning. Caught looking. Pozat would be next. Van Dam spiked it. That one made it about 58 feet or so. Sixty-eight pitches for Jake Van Dam. He can look well beyond this inning. You don't want to get ahead of yourself and start losing some guys. But boy, he could go 7 or 8 easily at this pace. That's a tough take right at the top of the zone. 3-1 from Mills. Three-one pitch and fouled. Mills needs 2 more walks for a career high and 5 more for the most in a season in Kalamazoo history. He's got twice as many walks as anybody else in this lineup with 28 coming into today. Big number. Full count pitch. And right back at him on the comebacker. Van Dam got him out. Jake Van Dam still dealing. Line out. Ground out, ground out. See you later. Hornets bringing in another arm here for the top of the sixth, Caden Sotomayor. Just mentioned we'd seen all righties so far. Now Sotomayor coming in as a left-hander, making appearance number 4 on the season, throwing just 2 2/3 so far, but yet to give up an earned run, knock on wood, and in fact, only 1 hit allowed with 3 strikeouts. Caden Sotomayor, a tall left-hander, a junior from Royal Oak, goes 6'3", 190. Not a Brother Rice. Sotomayor facing Charlie Saul here in the top of the sixth. One more defensive change. The Hornets go Cam Kelly in right field for Lockhart. First pitch from Sotomayor, and Pozat caught that one a little funny. Also a correction on the hitter. Jace DeMann is pinch hitting here for Caleb Saul. We do still have Chris Ann on deck, but maybe some of the regulars can get the rest of the day off with the Dutch having the comfortable lead there. Jace DeMann, a sophomore outfielder from Byron Center. He's got the 1-1 here. Sotomayor, big breaker, couldn't get it at the top of the zone. Pozat again having to flip the glove over to catch that one. It's 3-1. Only other left-handed options in the bullpen, Clayton Krizak and Matt Butterly. Can't worry too much about playing matchups here in a game where you're just sort of surviving and you're already having to burn a number of your bullpen arms anyway. You're very much deep in the heart of the season here. MIAA play, yeah, every game means a lot. But in the end, you wouldn't. When you get to the tournament, pretty much anything can happen, which we saw last year with Adrian turning it on in a big way on offense and winning that tournament. First pitch to Krizan is a beauty. Sotomayor largely reliant just on the slider. Also throws a fastball. Bounce this one. Good block. 8 runs, 8 hits for the Dutch. No runs, 3 hits for Kalamazoo. Be lying if we said it wasn't a bit of a shocker. Slider right towards the top of the zone. Not quite close enough. Kalamazoo was 44th in the nation coming in with that 322 average as a team. And they have been silenced today. Jake Van Dam with an outing to remember. They throw back and make it a little bit close on the pickoff throw. Hornets are even inside the top 50 nationally in team ERA at 4.17. A lot of surprising storylines from today. This is a base hit through the right side. And that's maybe the only time today that we haven't seen a base runner try and stretch it for an extra base there going first to third. Krizan, couple of base hits. Sotomayor now, 2 on, nobody out. Eight runs, 9 hits for the Dutch. Seabaugh, 2 out of 3. Drove in the first run. Now the rare fastball from Soto across for a strike. Reinhardt in just inside the cut of the grass. Everybody else more relaxed on the infield. A Mills, of course, plays a little bit closer to the bag than Steckow does. Want to give yourself a chance on a ground ball to the right side of possibly turning two. A twist and a miss. Seabaw is gone. Big punch out for Sotomayor. Now you've seen Cummins in a real similar scenario to this, as that's another beautiful slider across for strike one. Similar scenario meaning facing Brendan Collins with a couple of runners on, in a double play scenario. Step off then a real lollipop. Hard to call that a pickoff throw in all seriousness. Van Dam will likely be coming back out with 71 pitches to start the next inning. 0-2. Three hits, walked one for Jake Van Dam, four strikeouts. Has all the makings of a career day for him, and it would be a lot to celebrate in the standings, too. Sotomayor, 0-2. High. Sotomayor, fourth pitcher for the Hornets. Amodio went one inning. This is slow on the ground. Could be two. Steckow to turn it. Not quite in time. Just wasn't quite hit hard enough.
Now batting number eight, Nolan Gardner.
6-4 put out at second base. Fielder's choice for Collins to reach. The man, the pinch hitter, is now on third base. First pitch for Gardner, pulled inside the glove of Newland. Score one more. Mills cuts it off, 9-0. And Gardner has not been out today. Guy's on fire, 2-for-2, has the walk, the hit by pitch, now an RBI. And still on first base, Collins on third. Nine nothing, top six. Sotomayor still not nearly out of this. Keeps getting the first pitch sliders across, and they are good. Newson, a single, a walk, a stolen base. In on his hands. And staying away from the right-handed hitters seems like it's got to be the play for Soto, the left-hander. Even if you can't get those strike calls. Went way up and in. Pozat bluffed a throw. He was never throwing that thing. Gardner moves from first to second. Caden Sotomayor, 1-2, close. I mean really close. Two stolen bases now for the Dutch. Have not been caught. Soto again. A 2-2. Bounced it. Thankfully up the third baseline. If you're going to block it, that's a great spot for it to go. Can Sotomayor get out of this inning here? Will this load the bases? Money would be next. Full count. And off the glove from Reinhardt. That might bring in two more. Throw cut off. 11-0 Dutch. Devin Mjusen seemingly puts this thing to bed. Two-run single for Mjusen. Gardner in, Collins in. Both touch home, and a three spot here in the sixth. That pickoff throw quite high. Newland somehow brought it down. We'll recap the action for you real quick in this inning. Demand, the pinch hitter, walked. Krizan singled. From there, it looked like they were going to have a really good chance to get out of it as there's a slider over for a strike. Seabaugh struck out. Then Collins reached on a fielder's choice, which had a 6-4 put out to it. So there's two outs at that point. Then single, stolen base, two-run single. This is a soft flare to right. That thing's dropping in for a base hit. I mean, you just hit them where they ain't. 11 runs, 12 hits. You've now got multiple hits for Krizan, Seabaugh, Gardner, Mjusen, Money. And they might be looking to make another change here. Coach Ellenbest out again. We'll set the rest of the Hornets staff for you. Of course, Mike Ott is their fearless leader in year number 12. And for about 2 years now, he's been the program's all-time winningest coach. Assistant coaches, rather. Matt Ellenbest, Brendan Craig, J.P. McBride, Ryan Beadle, and Matt Rehfeldt. Hornets captains for the year are Lucas Bolton, Cooper Mills, Brendan Oprinski, and Harrison Pozat. Lots of experience there, a couple of seniors and a couple of fifth years. Sotomayor has been ahead of almost everybody and starting everyone off with sliders, mostly for strikes. Then when they work deeper into the count, these Dutch hitters just get pitches to hit. That's a ball in the dirt. That isn't one of those said pitches to hit. And Pickett looking to join the hit party. Doesn't have one yet, only started without one. 0 for 2, couple of punch outs. Still, two outs, that's your silver lining. Another slider in the dirt. And an appeal on a check swing, 2-0. An unexpectedly long half inning. Hornets got four more trips up to bat to erase a giant, giant hope lead. That ball is hit about a mile high. Hawkins drifting over right by the line and snags it in the corner. Three runs in. You had walk, single, strikeout, fielder's choice, single, stolen base, two-run single, one more single. The Dutch playing small ball to the absolute definition. And they lead by a whole bunch to nothing. Bats coming back out, bottom of the sixth. So the Hornets look like they're giving some of their regulars the rest of the day off as well. Didn't anticipate that maybe, but I think those last three runs were kind of the catalyst. Liam Regan will now be in Harrison Posat's spot. Good news is he's your reserve catcher, so he'll just slide right in there defensively. And on deck is Daniel Beccari. Jake Van Dam. Still out there dealing. That was pitch number 72 for a ball. Way up and in, though. Hornets going to have to get a whole lot in not a lot of time in order to make this one interesting. And at that point, maybe you'll be down some of your bats that you wish you had. That's always the catch 22 of it. But it's a long season. Can only win one game at a time. 3-1 on Regan. Van Dam only walked one. Now make that two, ball in the dirt. Pinch hit, walk. Jace DeMand, the pinch hitter, slid in right field. He takes over for Charlie Saul. And now they're out to visit with Van Dam. It looked like he might be done. Wasn't necessarily expecting him to get the hook that quickly this inning. Still, you can't take anything away from him. An absolutely unbelievable start from him. He has dominated one of the most talented lineups in Division III baseball, and I don't think he's ready to come out. He isn't going to come out yet. The Dutch appear to have 29 Matt Blesch up and throwing in their pen. This Kalamazoo team tied their program record with 31 wins last year. That was tied with the 2017 team. In the last 3 years, they've been in the top five all time. They're going to have to really turn it on, and you can't lose a whole lot more games if you're going to get there this season. They won the MIAA last year for the first time since 1927. And if they want to repeat, this isn't going to help. It's the 193rd meeting all time between these two teams, by the way. And this ball is hit with some authority. Beccari pinch hit single. First two pinch hitters both on. Now how long can they go before chasing Van Dam? Stu Fritz and his staff gonna be keeping close eye on their starter there. And I wonder if they were talking about perhaps that hangnail injury that it looked like he had ripped off earlier in the game. That's a really good pickoff throw back to second. Ooh, Liam Regan's gotta probably stay a half a step closer to the bag there. Dylan Rodriguez pinch hits for Tanner Hawkins here. Rodriguez shows bunt, pulled it back. Dylan Rodriguez, sophomore outfielder from Valparaiso. Counts 1-1 here. Rodriguez in his limited opportunities is 3 out of 5. Also driven in a run. I think they took the bunt off. And it appears they did. Up high, 2-1. No runs, but now 4 hits for Kalamazoo. They just got their second walk to lead off the inning for Regan. That's a great pitch, still spotted on the black. Jake Van Dam better get the Gatorade shower. The game ball, maybe the MIAA pitcher of the week. Time will tell, but man, he's been special. Froze Rodriguez there with a big hook. And a punch out.
Now batting number 6, Alex DeDio.
Alex DeDio is the next pinch hitter, and on deck is going to be another with Leo Schinker. DeDio's got 13 at-bats on the season, and he's also performed quite well in that limited time. 5 of 13 with a double, couple RBIs. No way for Van Dam to plan against some of these hitters that he's seeing. Line drive to right. You had the right fielder circling. And that was the defensive replacement, Demand. Wind's picking up a whole bunch here in this inning, too. So that probably made that ball do some funny things off the bat. So the first two in the inning walked and singled. Now you got a strikeout and a flyout and 2 out. Leo Schinker, the Sasebo, Japan native, is hit by a pitch.
Now batting number 13, Caleb Moore.
Bases quickly are loaded. First time, in fact, the Hornets had the bases loaded today. So now the most recent pinch hitter, don't worry, we've got more on deck, and we might see just about everybody on that Hornet bench, but Caleb Moore now pinch hits for Alex Finkel. And he's just a bit ahead of that one, but that ball was scorched. The next guy on deck, if he turns around here, try and get a look at it. I thought for a moment it was Braden Massat. I think it's actually 30, Ryan Witt. Massat's gotten a few at-bats in his career and famously has a hit. 1-2 here on Caleb Moore. Little excuse me, check swing to third, money, double pumps, and a tough tumble at third base plus the out. Moore giving it 110% down that line, but Jake Van Dam escapes the bases loaded jam, and if he's done, got to think you'd say that's the best start of his career. fantastic as he's kept the Hornets off the board all day. Top seven coming up. Time to play the top of the seventh, and we'll try and get all of the changes to you. You saw that last half inning kind of induced some chaos on the lineup card. So the first thing, Ben Van Ness takes over for Caden Sotomayor. Soto throws just the one inning with the three runs coming in the sixth. Ben Van Ness on the mound now, right-hander, sophomore from TC Central, 6'2", 185. Daniel Beccari to third base for Ryer Reinhart. His day is done. Rodriguez to left field for Hawkins. DiDio to second base for Steckow. Schenker to first base for Newland. Liam Regan, of course, to catcher from Posat. Caden Priesing to, or Pricing rather, to shortstop for Cooper Mills. Couple more changes in the outfield as well. Joe Leonard to center field for Bolton. And Ryan Witt to right field for Cam Kelly. Ben Van Ness ready for delivery number one. A little high. Numbers on BVN. Making appearance number nine on the season. 12 and two-thirds innings, 4.97 ERA. 18 punch-outs, that's good for 12.8 Ks per nine. And this is skied about a mile high. Great communication in that outfield. That ball's hauled in by Witt.
Now batting number 31, Jace DeMann.
Jace DeMann, pinch hit a couple innings ago. Now he's up again. Right down the pipe with a fastball. Van Ness has one spot start, also has a record of 1-0. Eight walks in those 12 and two-thirds, pretty respectable. All in all, becoming a reliable part of the bullpen. Sturzma likely going to finish 1-for-5 on the day. Kalamazoo did a good job on him. But got it from tons of other different guys. And speaking of got it, there's a hit by pitch from DeMann. Sturzma drove in one run with the RBI double. But you got three RBI. Of course, still the biggest swing of the game was Brendan Collins with that three-run homer. Cade Seabaugh, 2-for-4 RBI. Al Money, 2-for-3 RBI. Two runs driven in from Miusen, one from Krizan, one from Gardner. Everybody, 1-9. Real slow on the ground to short. They flip for one. That's all they're going to get. Another ball just not hit hard enough. The man is the lead runner. He's out.
Now batting number three, Cade Seaball.
Krizan on the fielder's choice. Seaball coming up. Been an eventful six pitches for Van Ness so far. Fly out, hit by pitch, now fielder's choice. And on the very first pitch, it's going to get a little bit too far out of here. Over by the batting cages. Schenker holding the runner on, at least nominally, over there at first. Krizan's not going anywhere. Cut right through it at the top of the zone. Krizan's got those 12 stolen bases. He's actually 12 for 12, but I just don't expect in a game that you're this well in hand with it that you're going to attempt to steal any bases. Still 0-2. Van Ness bringing heat, largely fastball at the top of the zone, and it's working. Oh and two, and a base hit through the left side. Single, that's three hits for Seaball. 11 runs, 13 hits.
Now batting number 16, Brendan Collins.
I think very few people would have told you, or if anybody would have told you that this game would end 11-0, probably wouldn't have believed him. Now, there's still some at-bats to go for the Hornets, but they've got to get some runs in the bottom here to even extend this game, let alone really make it interesting. Little high. The runners on are Krizan as well as Seaball. And Brendan Collins gets another chance. 0 for 3 since that three-run homer. And he went golfing. Much like the golf swing of yours truly, comes up empty. If Van Dam's day is done, he goes 6 innings, 4 hits, 2 walks, 5 strikeouts, and 55 out of 90 pitches thrown for strikes. Stellar. On the 2-1. And Regan tried to pull that thing down, couldn't do it. Still, good news is you got the two outs. Take everything positive that you can out of this game and on to the next. It's the beauty of 40-plus game regular season. 3 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Van Ness, full count. Do it one more time. So the Hornets have 1 through 9 made changes at every position. Ben Van Ness is now the 5th guy to throw. Gabe Sokol only lasted the 1/3 of an inning. And the full count pitch is down. Load the bases one more time. It went Sokol to Cummins. Cummins largely threw well. Went 3 2/3, 4 hits, 2 earned. Reese Amodio went one inning, a hit, and a walk with one run. And then Caden Sotomayor, an inning, four hits, three runs. Van Ness trying to just keep it where it is. You would need two runs in the bottom to extend it as it sits right now. Nobody has gotten Nolan Gardner out today. Really got to change that if you're Kalamazoo. Walk, hit by pitch, couple of singles, a run scored. This is slicing to left, and it's down. This thing could clear the bases. Are you kidding me? 14-0. Oh, and a dangerous little collision there. Van Ness with some of the runners that had scored. Fourteen runs, 14 hits. Nolan Gardner. Now he might be making his push for MIAA Player of the Week. That's actually the first error from anybody today. I was just about to say it's been a clean defensive game. All that error does is just allow the runner to move over to third base. But it is a three-run double from Gardner. Ball inside. Collins, Seabaugh, Krizan all came in to score. Mayusin's got two RBIs of his own. One ball, two strikes. If that error had just happened earlier for Van Ness, then those runs wouldn't have been earned. That would be nice, in a way. A 1-2. Fouled off. Do you believe in the last four innings, or really a little bit less than four innings, the Dutch offense has 9 out of their 14 runs? Pretty incredible. Another 1-2. Another foul ball. Ryan Witt is scheduled to hit next. Then Leonard and Pricing. That's 8-9-1. In the air. Shallow right field and hauled in by Witt. Well, looks like we'll be able to get you out of here in good time. Bottom of the 7 coming up. Hornets need a number of runs to extend it.
Like it. I'm not gonna lie. I've literally never seen this ever.
Time for the bottom of the seventh. The Hornets looking to scratch some runs across, keep this thing alive. They're facing Thomas Bacialupo. He started off Ryan Witt with a strike. And that's far outside. So Jake Van Dam is finished with those six shutout innings, just four hits and two walks with five strikeouts. Definitely going to consider that a career best start for him. One ball, two strikes. Bacialupo quickly ahead. And the Dutch can make the rather short trip back to the coast. Seemingly going to be very happy. It's not the largest win in, again, the 96-plus year history of these two teams meeting, but it's not super far off. That biggest win of all time, 21-1 back in the 1990s. Bacialupo, 2.45 ERA, making appearance number 7 on the year. Little high, and he walked the leadoff hitter.
Now batting number 11, Joe Leonard.
Bacialupo has thrown 11 innings so far for the year, struck out 11 and only walked 4. But an inauspicious start. Joe Leonard in for Bolton, and he watches a ball. Joe Leonard's a freshman outfielder from DeWitt. Stands 6'1", 175. Everybody tasked with survival here and trying to scratch a couple across. Chase up high. Down and away, 2-2. Should this shutout hold, it'll be the Hornets' first time being shut out this year. Their lowest scoring output to this point has been 2 runs. Back on Saturday, as Leonard watches one and is punched out. So they played a doubleheader at Adrian on Saturday. That first game lost in 8 innings, 12-2. And then they came back and won the second half of it, 10-4. That's the kind of bounce back offense that they have and they can bring out on any given day. They also have a season high of 28 runs scored at Earlham, so they can put up a crooked number whenever they want, and they got another game with 20 runs back shortly before spring break. That was back on February 24th. They've run the gamut of sort of all the possible outcomes this season. Still, this should run them to 19-8. But again, those all-important MIAA standings, this could hurt a little bit. Cade Pricing down 0-2. Bacialupo sets. It looked like a checked swing and must have held up. Now they're going to appeal, and he did not go. This will likely drop the Hornets to 8-4 in MIAA play. The Dutch will go to 10-2. And another strikeout looking. Bacialupo dealing a little bit himself.
Now batting number 16, Riley Weber.
Riley Weber is the next pinch hitter for the Hornets. Just like almost everybody else, he has contributed really well in limited playing time. 3 of 5, scored a couple of runs, and driven in a run. Weber for Regan. One Hornets down theoretically to their final out. Weber's down 0-2. Bacialupo could send this game to bed where it belongs. Ooh, he nearly did it there. Weber somehow held up. Women's lacrosse scheduled for 7 p.m. tonight. There's tons more Hornets athletic events. We'll get that to you right at the end of the game. Tell you all about everything upcoming this week. A little bit outside again. And it got him. Hornets put a couple on, a walk, and a hit by pitch. Bakari really stroked one nicely his last at bat. Line drive over third base. And of the pinch hit variety, it certainly helped fire him up a little bit. Bacialupo's already thrown 20 pitches. First pitch swinging, popped up on the edge of the infield and caught. The Dutch are going to celebrate one of the largest wins in the history of this rivalry. They record 14 runs on 14 hits. An absolute anomaly. They score 9 out of the 14 in the last four innings, from the fourth through the seventh. They finish, again, with those 14 runs on 14 hits. Every starter getting in on it. Robbie Sturzma had an RBI double. Owen Krizan, 2-for-4. Nolan Gardner had one of the biggest hits with the 3-run double. Brendan Collins had that 3-run bomb back in the first inning. Devin Meusen, 2-for-4, a couple of RBIs. Krizan, 2-for-4, RBI. Cade Seabaugh, 3-for-5 RBI. Al Money, 2-for-3 RBI. Just about everybody. Hard to even pick the most outstanding Dutch performer. I still think I would go with Jake Van Dam, starting pitcher. 6 innings of stellar work, 4 hits, 2 walks, 5 strikeouts, and the all-important shutout. Thomas Bacialupo shuts the door. Records a couple of strikeouts, the 1 walk in that 7th inning. Hornets, with no runs on 4 hits, get a single from Pozat, Reinhardt, Bakari, and Steckow. Not much else. Hornets never strung the runs together. Never strung the hits or the on base together, really. Now, for all those upcoming athletic events, here's what we're going to bring you. Women's lacrosse, again, hosts Albion tonight at 7 p.m. We're fully in the thick of it with the spring sports, so here comes everything else. Men's lacrosse tomorrow night versus Adrian at home. Softball plays doubleheaders on Wednesday, Thursday, and Saturday. That's Olivet, Aquinas, and Hope. Finally, baseball will be back here on Sunday afternoon for doubleheader with Trine. I'll be covering the softball games on Thursday with Aquinas. If you didn't catch any of that, I do not blame you at all. Remember to check the athletics website at hornets.kzoo.edu. From Woodworth Field, Kalamazoo College, with Kalamazoo Baseball, I'm Tanner White. Thanks so much for joining us.